Hello and welcome, my friend. And then I am planning to show you that how I can notice that in that my car there is engine failure and bad bearing damage and issue in this my engine. And the method is now that we can find this error when we listen that engine. And then I start this engine and I will show that how I can know that what tells that we have engine failure in that my engine. Okay, and now I start this engine that we can listen this engine bearing failure sound. Okay, and now engine is running well, but then when I accelerate a little bit more, this engine starts to keep that bad sound. Listen. In that area I can add more revs and soon we can hear small hammering sound. It is that. Okay, and let's listen again. Now sound is okay, but then that sound, what comes when I give revs? It is sometimes. Okay.
Okay, and then we can listen this knocking sound. And I say that when this sharp.
Okay, and there was this really
now,
this bad hammering sound, and I try to demonstrate that sound. And it is something like that when I add these revs in here, and sometimes there is that kind of small hitting. Like that something was hitting like this my hammer. And sometimes what it could be. I believe now that when here we have this car engine's piston, what moves in here. And this is connection rod, and here we have these connection rod bearings. That this area and these parts, they are too worn out. And that's this my connection rod. This connection rod makes small extra movement in that way. And this makes that bad sound. But this is my estimation. But the final truth is that there is now bearing issue, and it is either either this connection rod or then crankshaft bearings, and they are failure. And let's look when I take that engine next out, and we can look that engine more, that what is issue in there. Okay, and then I continue. Hello, my friend, and how are you doing? And next I am planning to tell you that why this my car is keeping hammering sound when I start the engine, and then I little bit add more revs, and then this engine keeps like small hammering sound. And where this sound come from? And now I have really situation that I have take out these parts, and now I am in final step for this issue solving, that what makes this small hammering. And this small hammering sound, it is something like that. When I at my revs to 2000, my engine keeps that kind of look, this arena here. The small, that kind of sound. Of course, a little bit faster, but something is knocking all time. And now I have found the thing. This is this connection rod bearing. And then when I take that out, and there is this connection rod and piston, and there another side, there is also similar bearing. I made huge invention. I take my pool that we can check that better. And then when I insert these two connection rods in there, we can see when we take a little bit closer view also, of course. And here is, by the way, my new connection rod. There is this my area. And then when we look in closer view, we can see that this, there's something strange. This is, when we look this my old connection rod bearings, we can see that there is interesting, it is like material is away in that area. And also in this second, and that means that there is huge material loss in those bearing plates. And then when we compare, this is like brand new bearing plate. And then when we compare those things, we can see that there is really, really big difference. And let's look even closer that what is this situation. When we look, we go to closer and even closer, and soon I made a little bit better view. Now we have better view, and then when we look in this, look, there is huge material loss. And this one is like brand new, and this is brand new, and these are old. And there is huge material loss if I show that we look in this side area. They are totally bad. And this thing makes this bad sound in this hammering sound. I have really bad connection rod bearing issue. And finally, and now I can maybe fix that if I replace those new connection rods bearings plates. This is this bearing plate, but there is of course risk that if we look a little bit bigger view, that if this area where is this connection rod takes contact, that if that area is damaged, then I have to also finish and make that part of this crankshaft also in good condition. But the point is that what makes this bad sound in my engine, the result is that it is this connection rod bearings, and there are those two filures plates and that another one in here. This is like brand new, and look especially this shape. There is big holes in here, like almost 1 millimeter deep holes in this bearing, and this makes this hammering sound. Okay, thank you. Okay, and then connection rod bearings replace, and here we have this old one, and they looks like that. And then when I am planning to install new one, we need to purchase new one at these connection rod bearings. And the best one is of course when we go to purchase these Toyota's original at these connection rod bearings. It is the best one. But now I try to test this made in Israel. This is King style, and there is good quality standards. And this King engine bearing, they made bearings for aircraft, airplanes. And that's, I think, that I can test this. And I have purchased this from ebay.com, and they have sales office in this New Jersey, Cedar Grove area. And there is kingbearing.com webpage. And this bearing should be in good quality. And then I open this bearings. And then, by the way, this Israel, they makes also very good quality Uzi machine gun, and I have tested it, and it works really well, Uzi machine gun. And that's also, I think, that if they do good guns, these bearings should be also good. Okay, and then when I am installing this new bearing, this is this old one, and they must be in just similar. And I checked that those all things are together. Okay, it looks good. And then when I install this new bearing, there is in Toyota way that there is this joint dent where that part goes directly in here. And then I need to only press that in that way. And now this bearing is in position. And let's go to look closer. Now this bearing is in position, and then when I replace it, I only press that in a little bit in here, and there is this small dent in here, look. There is this dent area in here, and also in here, that part. And this part goes firstly in this dent, and then I only press that in here. And then they are in chain play. And now this bearing, it has been replaced in here. And then of course, when I have this piston, I have to insert the similar part in this another crankshaft area in here. In that way. Good. And now this bearing is in position. Excellent. And then I can take these old bearings away. Okay, and now this piston, this one, is ready for back installation to engine block. Okay, and then we can continue.